the Sona motivates. Sona motivates you to eat healthy, be happy, and enjoy every moment. Welcome to our Facebook Live Spice Series. It's week 18 and we are going to talk about carom seeds, and they are nature's pharmacy. Most famous, this spice is famous for nature as a nature's pharmacy. Three very incredible health benefits of carom seeds or ajwain or bishop's weed. That's what it is called as. Okay, let's see if we can get connected with other people. Perfect, here we are. Okay, welcome to Sona Motivates once again. And today we are going to jump right away on in our first health benefits, and that is about carom seeds. How and why it is nature's call as nature's pharmacy. So back then, when there weren't any painkillers available, or even if they were, people were not aware about it. And that's when they used to have the ajwain or these carom seeds water. And you just steep the water in the distill, steep the carom seeds in the distilled water, and then you have it twice a day or maybe three times a day, just the warm water with these seeds, and it used to help and it used to work wonders. People have actually healed arthritis pain and migraine and basic any kind of pain because with the help of these carom seeds. And why? Still, back then when they used it, it wasn't known, but it people definitely, the Ayurvedic practitioners definitely swore on the use of these carom seeds. But when the scientists researched about these carom seeds, they found out that there are more than two dozen components, the healthy components, which help you heal the body. That's what the carom seeds can have them. And one of them is as strong as morphine. So when you have these carom seeds, it acts as good as it has morphine in it. And let me see if there are any comments. Okay, perfect. We already have two comments here, and I see, hi Nimisha, thank you for joining, and I see Monica as well. Thanks Monica for joining in. So I was talking about carom seeds and why and how they are beneficial in as a painkiller or pain reliever as such, because they have this one strong ingredient as strong as morphine. And when you actually try to eat carom seeds, have you noticed that for a little bit, because of course it is very hot and it has that very peculiar taste, for a couple of second, maybe a split of second, you feel numbness on your tongue if you try to eat it raw. And this is because of the thymol. The thymol that's present in the carom seeds, it actually numbs the tongue for a while, and that's what it helps. When you have the carom seeds when you're in pain, they actually have the numb effect on your body, and that's how they are supposed to relieve the to help us relieve from the pain. And that was very interesting to know. Hi Chroma, thank you for joining in. Try to use carom seeds in the in cooking the beans, any kind of beans, just add a couple of them because they are excellent for digestion, and we will jump over for that health benefit later. But let me tell you some facts about carom seeds, how it helped me previously when I was and it was unknowingly actually when I was trying to consume the carom seeds for my cold, how I figured out that it also helps you relieve the pain. So a couple of years back I was actually diagnosed with herniated discs, and I have two herniated discs in my in the spinal cord, in the lower back, and it hurts. It at that time actually it used to hurt a lot. And when we went to the chiropractor, she actually suggested that I should stop acting like, and that's what exactly what she talked about, that I should stop acting like a super mom, and you know, I should at least thrice a week I should go to her for all the exercises and whatever she used to suggest me, and I should stop all exercising myself, you know, workouts, I shouldn't lift, I shouldn't bend, and all this. And I clearly remember when, after coming from her office, I was like, while sitting in the car with my husband, I was boggling. Because me being so active, I like to work out, I like to dance, I like to go for long walks. And when I heard all this, it was like, oh my god, I cannot do anything anymore. And little did I know that during that time, actually, I was also suffering from a little bit of cold. And we are so used to use these carom seeds for cold. Actually, what we do if you are suffering, even for the little kids, if someone is suffering from the cold symptoms like a sore throat, cold, I used to just put some in the boiling water and take the steam of these carom seeds or ajwain, or we would just even on the pan, you just throw a couple of on the hot heated pan, throw a couple of carom seeds, and even the dry steam, the heat, it helps you heal. It helps you relieve, and you it acts like soothing. It has a soothing effect on yourself, and you feel like you feel sleepy and calm when you inhale the carom seeds. And that's how I was using it. And of course, I tried to listen to the chiropractor, but I still did some of my research, and I have seen some of the great weightlifters who had herniated this. So at least I knew that it shouldn't stop me from working out or doing what I love, like dancing. Of course, I have to be a little careful with what moves I do, but eventually you learn how to deal with any kind of ailments you have. And today I can lift weight, I work out regularly, I dance a lot, I do kickboxing, which I do, I love to do kickboxing, and it didn't affect my lifestyle. So the bottom line for telling this whole thing to you guys is that if something, even if of course you have to listen to the doctors and the specialists, but always believe in yourself. If you think something, your body knows you well, so you know how much it is affecting you. So it's always nice to hear somebody telling you that you should rest, and but you have to take to the next level and try to understand whether is it your body really telling it, or it's just a little bit of laziness. So trying to figure out that. But I was very fortunate enough that during that time, because I was having the cold, I started having this carom seed water. I was also inhaling them because of the cold, and eventually I started noticing that my body, my back was not hurting that much. It somehow it was really, of course, I did the chiropractor sittings for 3 weeks, and I did some research, and I was trying to always use the heated and the cold pack, and it was also helping a little bit of massage. And I have to tell you this, that I didn't stop walking. Even if I was in a little bit of pain, and you can say it was more of a discomfort, I still made sure that I was walking. I took walks, I would sit in between, but I will still keep walking. And I had, I'll measure my steps, and I'll see where it is paining. So it did help me. So even if you feel, that's something is bothering you, and if you your healthcare practitioner or your doctor is saying, you have to really listen to your body, be vigilant. So jumping back to our carom seeds, this is how it helped me. And I do believe that carom seeds do have some kind of these pain relieving effect on your body. So even if your kids or your somebody loved ones or you yourself are suffering from any kind of pain, right, from from migraine to arthritis, try using these carom seeds. Like I talked last week, make sure you any kind of this medication, make sure you use it for 21 days. So maybe if you're starting to use this carom seed water, make sure you start doing it from tomorrow and try to use it for next 21 days. See the effects on your body. Be vigilant about yourself, and let us know how you feel about it, whether it was helpful, whether it wasn't, it wasn't effective at all. What did you do right? What didn't help you? Because that's how we will come to some kind of conclusions whether it's helping. And it did help me though. So please try it and let us know. Okay. So now what are carom seeds or the carom plant? It is also called ajwain in the Indian language, Hindi. And it is also called as bishop's weed. So these carom seeds or ajwain, it's a small plant. It's actually very much, it's the same family from cumin or parsley family. It has a very peculiar aroma and it's actually very soothing as well. Like I told, this is how they look like, carom seeds. This is how they look. They are oval with they have some ribs on them, and they are very they are hot, and but they are very tasty. Actually, they taste well. Very commonly they are used after lunch or dinner to soothe for any kind of indigestion issues. Okay, I see Sanjay joining in. Thank you, Sanjay, for joining. And thanks, Nimisha. Yes, I am a warrior with friends like you. Yes, I was suffering from very bad herniated disc, but last year actually we did tree trekking in Orlando, and I was able to do all the levels, and I was so happy because nothing stopped me, even the herniated disc pain. So if you guys are going through any kind of body discomfort or pain, make sure you go through it. I know it's a struggle, but make sure you listen to your body, try to work out as much as you can, eat right, and of course have all these great spices, because they are healer. You don't have to go to the medicine cabinet right away, because you have the medicine right in your kitchen. Okay, so now we are going to our next health benefit, and that's what it is. Actually, carom seeds are very, very commonly used for any kind of respiratory or asthma issues, any kind of respiratory health issues or asthma, a common cold, sore. And I have already talked about all these in the other spices, but these specifically we have been using even for the little kids. Now why? Of course, we talked about thymol just now, and thymol is great. It has anti-inflammatory and it has antibacterial properties. Like I said, it numbs the pain, so they are excellent. But apart from that, carom seeds also have choline. And what does choline do is actually it has that kind of it is a nutrient that aids the brain. It sends the brain the healing messages. So it gives the brain that kind of cooling and soothing effect. That's why they are really, really work well in any kind of cold or cough issues. Not only that, actually it helps to relieve the phlegm, the mucus from the body, and that's how the asthma problem is solved. Not only that, the carom seeds also have an acetylcholine, let me spell it right. Yes, it is called acetylcholine, and it is a chemical that actually controls the involuntary functions of your muscles. So like those from the guts, and even from like we were talking about the migraine issue or the arthritis or any kind of muscle pain in your body, it has that effect where these acetylcholine from the carom seeds help you control these kind of muscular moments. And then what happens is it helps you relieve from the pain. That's why these carom seeds or the ajwain, they are very, very commonly used for a new mom after the delivery. And we only knew about the some kind of special treats our ancestors or our grandmas and mom used to make with these carom seeds and fennel. Of fennel seeds and coconut, and we are going to jump into our third health benefit with that. But let me complete about the second health benefit, which says about carom seeds really help these boost respiratory health and asthma, cold and sore throat, because it has, of course, thymol, it has choline, and especially the acetylcholine. It is very, very helpful in controlling these involuntary muscular movements in your body. So how that's just now I told you how we use for to heal from the common cold is that you just just throw in couple of these cannabis, maybe a teaspoon or two teaspoons in a warm water, and then you inhale it, or you can also just put some of them in the heated pan, and then you try to take the steam of these carom seeds, and it helps you. Also, you can pack them in a tissue paper or even in any kind of cloth, and in a muslin cloth before sleeping, and put under your pillow. That way it's very, very soothing when you have any kind of pain issues, and it helps actually to make you sleep better as well. So try these home remedies for of course for the any respiratory issues, or also about any kind of pain. Now last but not least, hi Disha, thank you for joining, thank you for waving. Hi Arlene, thank you for joining. So I was talking about our third health benefit, and that is even in the breastfeeding, during the breastfeeding or for the breastfeeding of the new moms, because carom seeds are actually proved to clean the uterus. So scientists have proved that it helps clean the uterus, and of course relieve from the pain, and also help secrete the milk production. It helps you actually help you to increase the milk production for the new mom. So if you have suffering from any kind of these issues, please try the carom seeds. And now what we used to have back then is this: to roast these carom seeds, fennel seeds, and maybe the grated coconut, dry coconut, and even with the you can also add sesame seeds to it, and you roast these, dry roast them, put them all in a container, mix them, and you can some of them used to add a little salt to it, maybe a salt water for the little taste. But this is what always was there for the new moms to consume after every meal, and it helped them heal from of course all kinds of pains, cold, and because after pregnancy, after delivery, they are so prone, and their immunity, their immune system isn't that strong enough to fight fight any kind of infections, especially these common cold and stuff. So that that's when they are given these healing mix, you can say, after every meal, and it helps them big time. So carom seeds are actually not seeds, and they are, that was just a very interesting fact to know, they are actually fruits. They are fruits of ajwain or carom plant, and this is how they look, and these are the flowers, the carom flowers, and very, very, if you zoom them in a very, very minutely, you see they are small seeds, and when they dry, they look like this. They are kind of brown gray color. Now how do you use them? Now you can use them, like I said, in the water. You can steep this in the water, you can drink that water, you can have them like the mix I told right now, or you can dry roast them and then make a powder and use it. But I do like the crunch it gives, but some people, they don't like it, so you can powder them and use it. In India, they are very commonly used in breads, parathas we call in any kind of breads or puris. We also use them in pakoras or fritters. We make with the chickpea flour, and we have to add these, the carom seeds, because they are great for digestion process. They help any kind of digestive problems, like most of the spices, but they are excellent for any kind of digestive problem, or even heartburn, or flatulence, or indigestion. So try using them. And what more we use, you can also keep them in your spice box, and while tempering, add them to any of the dish you are using, or just a little bit goes long way, but it helps you digest the food very naturally. And when you actually temper them in an oil or ghee, it actually loses its the peculiar the hot spiciness, and the thymol, it does, it's still active, but it it doesn't hurt, you know, it doesn't have that kind of numbness. So you can, those who don't like that feeling, you can definitely use in tempering, add to your sauces, you can to your veggie stir fry, you can use that them there, of course to the white rice, brown rice, just a little bit, just throw in a little bit of this carom seeds, and if they are going to help you heal from the pain or respiratory issues or even, you know, with the any kind of uterus issues, so why not try to use them. And how are they used around the world? So I have noticed that, okay, let me go here. Ethiopian spice blend has a very, very, very peculiar taste, and it is because of this carom seeds or ajwain. In Afghanistan, they mostly use it for breads and pastries, and that was actually very that was very interesting to know, because I wasn't sure if people do use them in any kind of desserts or sweets, because we are so used to use them in any kind of spicy blends. You know, we use them in curries or, like I told, pakoras, and of course we do use them in breads, in parathas and puris. But they are excellent, and not only these, they are used for they help you really, used in case of hypertension, and all these spices have excellent health benefits regarding the cancer and cholesterol issues. So make sure you add them to your diet in some way. Now we are in our 18th week. We have known so much about these spices, and I'm sure it must be sometimes consuming and overwhelming, make sure you add at least one spice to your diet, you know, every week, maybe new spice, and try that for a while and then go back. But like I told, 21 days is best to form any kind of habit. So try it. This was very commonly used. This is very commonly used in our household for in case of cold. If you have any kind of cold or sore throat, and anything, as soon as my kids start complaining about, you know, any kind of these seasonal allergies, and this is the best home remedy. You know, it's always been there. Back home, actually, even the babies are given the steam of these ajwain or carom seeds. And okay, so it's almost 20 minutes, and I still have a little bit of time. Like last week, we started this series where I told you that I'm going to talk a little bit about me. I just told you how I was suffering from herniated disc, how these carom seeds have helped me. And I see Swapna Ravi joining in, and thank you, Swapna, for joining. Pleasant seeing you here. Let me add more about these. I also use the ginger water for any kind of pain, and it helps so much. So if anything is hurting, make sure you boil ginger, grate the ginger, boil it in the water, add a little bit of honey if you, it's okay, but I do add jaggery, and then you can add jaggery or a little bit of brown sugar, let it cool, and add lemon juice on it, and sip it the whole day if you can. Warm it a little bit and then sip it every now and then. Hi Archana, thank you for joining our Facebook Live, nice to see you here. So try using this ginger water, it helps big time. It does any kind of pain for 2-3 days. You just try it and let me know, because you know, last this Sunday we had a procession, and we danced like crazy in heat, and of course, when we dance, you know, because we almost walked for 3.5 miles, and we were dancing our traditional folk with the lejim, with one kind of, you know, appliance, you can say, or an instrument in hand. And if you can show the lejim picture, actually, that will be great. So if you can show, let's try it. But you know, we danced a lot and my feet were hurting so much, but this ginger water helped me a lot. And now I remember, while talking to you guys, I could have had this carom seed or even the ajwain water, but you know, next time. But try this ginger water if anything is paining, especially if after workout you have that kind of pain, you're sore, try using this ginger water remedy. I'm sure it will help you guys too. Okay, and one more thing. We talked about, I am going to introduce our products from G-Course. What I told last week, I have a food company, and then I'm going to show one product every week, and this is one of our products. It's called avocado wraps. They are made with only 5 ingredients: whole wheat flour, water, oil, salt, and avocado. That's it. And they, you can find them in any of those grocery stores local. Of course, we are still in South Florida, but you can find them in grocery stores, in the freezer section, in the cooler section. They last 3 to 4 weeks in the refrigerator and 3 to 6 months in freezer. Warm them on a heated pan and they puff like a very, very nice puri or roti. Hi, Lakshmi, for joining. Thank you very much. And this is what it is about. They are very versatile. You can use them for making tacos, or you can you can use them for making enchiladas or burritos, wraps, or even like a roti. And I haven't tried frying it, but people say they can. They also use them like puri. So if you are interested in frying it, I don't recommend frying, so probably I will not. But if you want to try it, please go ahead. Once in a while, it's okay. And Nimisha is suggesting we make fritters with the leaves of the spice. Yes, how can I forget that? Actually, yes, back home we had a small plant, and once in a while we used to make these fritters with the whole leaf as a of the spice, the ajwain fritters, and it's called pakoras, and they taste very good. Oh yes, thank you, Archana. Yes, we can actually make baked chips with it. So we did have 2 products which we are discontinuing because it's a little bit of there are some issues with it, but we actually added sugar, brown sugar and cinnamon, and baked it, and that was our sweet chips. And you can add any kind of, you know, spicy stuff on it, and you can make the chips with it. So they can very well like roti chips, nacho chips, and pita chips. That's why you can make the roti chips with this as well. So they serve very well with hummus, guac, or the spicy one, of course, or even with the Indian chutneys. And and the sweet one, actually my kids used to eat them with the ice cream, with the sugar and cinnamon, and it did taste good. So yes, thank you very much, Archana, for suggestion of about these baked chips. And I think we are almost done here. Yes, it was pleasant talking to you. Any kind of questions, feel free to ask. And this was all about our Carom Seeds, super healthy and awesome spice. Even if you don't learn, you missed the whole video and you have just last couple of minutes you joined in, make sure you start making the ajwain water. Just you know, now itself, take a pan with the water, add these ajwain seeds, let them be there for the whole night. In the morning, just boil them for a couple of minutes and then try sipping them the whole day, and keep doing this for 21 days and let me know how you feel about any kind of pain, any kind of pain or any issue of cold, sore, allergies or any kind, because these are actually natural pharmacy right there in your kitchen. So please guys, thank you very much for joining in. And Nisha is saying that my kids love them too. Yes, I still remember yes, Kishu eating them and his pictures. Yes, he used to like the sweet ones a lot. Thank you very much, Nisha, for joining, and thank you everybody for joining. And if you like this video, make sure you share. We also share all the our Facebook live videos on our YouTube channel, so if you are interested, and if you think your friends will be interested, make sure you share, comment, and leave any kind of questions for our next week's spice which you would like us to explore. Let us know and we will keep going. Thank you very much for joining in, and those who are watching this video later, thank you, and see you next week with a new spice. Bye for now.